Imagine how different the world would be if more people donated as generously as Ratan Tatas. Namaste. I know how much so many of you love and appreciate Tata Group, but did you know that Ratan Tata is not on the list of billionaires? Tata owns like 96 companies, so I have no idea how that is possible for him to not be on the list, but we're gonna find out now in this video.
Ratan Tata is richer than Bill Gates, and yet not in the list of billionaires. Here's why.
What?
Bill Gates maintains his position as the world's richest man in the Forbes annual list with a net worth of $86.0 billion.
Oh. Well, this is an old video.
Buffett, with a net worth of $75.6 billion, stands at 0.2, followed by big names including Mark Zuckerberg, Jeff Bezos, and others. But you'll be amazed to know that there actually is a multinational company that is making more money than all those whose chairpersons make it to the list of the wealthiest people on the globe. And this conglomerate is none other than the Tata Group of India. The company was founded by Jamsetji Tata in 1868 and gained international recognition after its association with various brands worldwide. Today, they are running 96 companies, and there exist 30 publicly listed Tata enterprises including Tata Steel, Tata Motors, Tata Consultancy Services, Tata Power, Tata Chemicals, Tata Global Beverages, Tata Teleservices, Titan, Tata Communications, Taj Group and several more, with a combined market capitalization of about $130 billion. In India, 4 out of 5 top-ranked responsible business companies belong to Tata Group. Why then is Ratan Tata, the former chairperson, and the Tata family's heir, never named among those making an insane amount of money? It is because 65% of the family's and the company's fortune is given away as charity. Thus, the profit made by many enterprises goes to charitable organizations.
Did you say 65%?
And it's not Ratan Tata's personal financial statement. Ratan Tata's net worth as an individual does not cross the 1 billion mark. Born on 28 December 1937, Ratan Tata is the son of Naval Tata, whom Navajbhai Tata adopted from Jay and Petit Parsi orphanage. He studied the arts at Cornell University and the advanced management program at Harvard Business School in 1975. He took up the position of Tata Group's chairman in 1991. Under his administration, the company's revenue increased by 40% and its profit by 50%. The Tata family has been involved in philanthropic work since their establishment. They have contributed a lot to the betterment of healthcare facilities, improving the education system, fighting for equal rights, sports, and preservation of arts in India. They were awarded the Carnegie Medal of Philanthropy in 2007.
That's awesome.
Their charity work is not limited to India, but they give away a percentage of their profit for international causes too.
65% of his, what was it? Net worth? Income? I don't know. Is donated to charity? That's insane. I know a lot of people make the joke like we should eat the rich and stuff, but like the thing about getting rich is that you can literally donate more money to any cause than anyone else of a lower economic status. So whether or not you make the choice to do that shows your character, but you know, you having a lot of money doesn't automatically make you a bad person. Obviously, when you're donating more than half of your, I don't know which word it was, if it was net worth or whatever, to charity, that is so generous. And obviously he's still able to afford whatever he wants, whenever he wants. It's just crazy. That's absolutely amazing. And it's really a shame that more people don't do this. And I'm not gonna say we need to take away a portion of the wealth of all the wealthiest people on the planet, but imagine how different the world would be if more people donated as generously as Ratan Tata's.
Tata Group donated Superscript $12.20 billion, $50 million, to the Harvard Business School, the largest amount received by the Institute from an international donor. The amount was given for the construction of an academic block and a residential building on the school's campus in Boston, Massachusetts. They also launched an in-home water purification device called Tata Swatch. This amazing product was sold for less than 1,000 rupees, US $21. Wow. What I would like to do is to leave behind a sustainable entity of a set of companies that operate in an exemplary manner in terms of ethics, is values and continue what our ancestors left behind. Raiden Tata Tata Consultancy Services Limited, TCS, designed a software that claims to teach an illiterate person how to read within 40 hours. The company makes sure its employees are taken care of. They introduced modern pension system, medical facilities, maternity leaves, and much more in their offices all over India. After the Taj Hotel was attacked, the Tata Group did not leave its employees helpless while the building was being renovated and was dysfunctional. In fact, all of the staff kept receiving their paychecks throughout this time. The company also compensated the railway employees, police staff, and even the pedestrians, the market vendors, and the shopkeepers. Following are some of their amazing institutes working for social welfare: the Energy and Resources Institute, a non-governmental research institute, the JRD Tata Eco Technology Center, National Center for Performing Arts, Tata Center for Technology and Design at Massachusetts Institute of Technology, Tata Center for Technology and Design at IIT Bombay, Tata Cricket Academy, Tata Football Academy, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Tata Management Training Center, Tata Medical Center, inaugurated on 16 May 2011 by Raiden Tata Tata Memorial Hospital, Tata Trusts, a group of philanthropic organizations, Tata Cancer Hospital. Recently, the Tata Group announced that they'll work to completely eradicate malaria from India. $70 million will be invested in constructing the Tata Institute of Genetics and Society in Bengaluru that will modify the DNA of Indian mosquitoes to make the country free of this deadly disease.
Wait, they're going to modify
Tata will himself hold a position as a trustee.
They're
going to
modify the DNA of the mosquitoes.
It is this vast variety of welfare work done on gigantic scales because of which the company cannot claim to be named among the richest ones in the world. Their priority is not making to any lists but to actually do valuable things to make this world a better place to live in. Wow. The love of public for Raiden Tata and the respect they give him is sufficient to make him feel like the wealthiest, the happiest, and the most satisfied man alive.
Dear friends, if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment my video.
Please. Amazing. You know, I already knew that Tata Group is beloved in India, but I had no idea the actual scale of their charity work and how much money they actually donate to people. I don't know, if everyone with massive amounts of money, I'm looking at you, Jeff Bezos, did what Raiden Tata does, if everyone who was a billionaire competing with each other to see who could do the most work, imagine what the world would be like. Who knows? Who knows? But, you know, that doesn't happen. So that just means that more people like Raiden Tata need to make that money and help other people. And it's possible, you just have to believe in yourself. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you next time. Make sure, oh, by the way, I'm starting another, I'm starting a different YouTube channel. I like the idea of the mobile one, the mobile YouTube channel, but I would rather do something else. So I'm gonna start a vlog channel specifically for blogs or vlogs about my work. So go check that out. I'll put a description somewhere, but anyway, yes, thanks for watching. I will see you later. Jai Hind.